I'll be delivering my statement in Arabic. So prepare yourself, please. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
In the name of God, the merciful, the compassionate. Mr. Chairperson, Excellency the Director General, Excellencies, heads of delegation, it gives me a great pleasure to extend to the permanent representative of the Kingdom of Morocco, Ambassador Abdullah Abohaimed, my sincere congratulations on his election chairman of this conference. I wish him all success. I take this opportunity to express also my appreciation to the representative of Germany, Christopher Isrank, the chairperson of the previous session. I thank him for his able stewardship of that session. I also commend the enormous efforts put in by His Excellency, the Director General of the OPCW, Ambassador Ahmed Zumchu. I thank him for all his efforts. I also thank all the TS personnel for their successful efforts. First of all, my delegation associates itself with the statement delivered on behalf of the NAM States parties and China, delivered by Ambassador Haifa Isami Madah, the permanent representative of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela. Mr. Chairperson, the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia reiterates the importance of implementing the convention. We believe that, based on our policy aimed at total disarmament of WMDs under strict and effective international monitoring in accordance to paragraph 1 of the preamble of the convention, we are committed to implementing the convention at the national and international level. This reflects our policy aimed at making an effective contribution to prohibiting all WMDs. We have also the ambition of making the Middle East zone free of these devastating weapons. We have called on many occasions on the international community to support this objective. We consider this objective to be a legitimate right of peoples in the region and an indispensable pillar for security and stability in our region. Mr. Chairperson, ladies and gentlemen, the use of chemical weapons under any circumstances is something that cannot be tolerated. This is reprehensible and needs to be condemned with the strongest terms. It is contrary to legal international norms of the international community. We feel grave concern with respect to the conclusions on the 7th report of the Joint Investigative Mechanism, which has concluded beyond doubt that the Syrian regime has used sarin at Khan Shaykhun in Syria on 4th of April 2017. That finding was based on sufficient, credible, and reliable evidence. That report also established that Daesh has used mustard gas in Omhush on 15th and 16th of September 2016. This delegation condemns the use of these lethal weapons in Syria, and we call all concerned parties to stop using these chemical weapons immediately in Syria, and we call for all individuals and parties involved in these attacks to be held accountable for their crimes. We also express our deep sympathy to the families of victims of these attacks. My delegation regrets that the special meeting of the EC held last week was concluded without taking without adopting the decision proposed by the United States of America and co-sponsored by my country and by Estonia and Colombia. That draft decision called for condemning the Syrian regime and Daesh for using chemical weapons in Syria. That draft decision enjoyed the support of many member states in the Council. Mr. Chairperson, we express our appreciation for the professionalism and transparency of the GIM team in conducting their work. However, at the same time, we regret that their mandate has not been extended for another year. This could lead to the impunity of perpetrators of those chemical crimes. This could send also the wrong message to the Syrian regime and would lead them to believe that the international community tolerates such use of chemical weapons. Mr. Chairperson, the Syrian regime must change its approach to resolve all issues related to their initial declarations. The Syrian regime must cooperate with the declaration assessment team. The mere exchange of correspondence with the TS without realizing any progress and the declaring of some parts of one of the important facilities in the Syrian program, that cannot be considered full cooperation with the technical secretariat of the OPCW. Therefore, my delegation calls the Syrian regime to cooperate fully and without conditions with the declaration assessment team and with the technical secretariat, and we call upon them to declare all components of their chemical program. Indeed, the seventh report of the GIM has established that they have retained some components of their chemical programs as a strategic choice in order for them to be able to use them if required. Mr. Chairperson, this delegation welcomes the completion of destruction of stockpiles by Libya and the Russian Federation. This demonstrates their commitment to fulfilling their implementations under the Convention. I also thank the states which have contributed to these important milestones in the elimination of the chemical weapons threat. Mr. Chairperson, the Convention emphasizes the importance of economic and technological development and the international cooperation in the field of activities not prohibited under the Convention. We value past achievements in this regard. However, we need to do more and to put in further efforts to implement the requirements of Article 11, especially with regard to the transfer of technology and material and expertise related to chemical industries and activities not prohibited under the Convention, and transfer of that expertise to the developing nations. And you also call for the lifting of obstacles by some states in this regard. Such exchange would contribute to promoting global economic development and would benefit all the states. In this context, I wish to note that the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia has always supported the OPCW Associate Program by providing placements for trainees in the Saudi company Sabic. Also, my country calls for further implementation of Article 10 and the provision of assistance and protection by the OPCW and by other states' parties which are able to do so. And in this respect, it is my great pleasure to inform you that the Health Ministry in Saudi Arabia has organized a training program for first responders and medical practitioners on the response to chemical threats and decontamination and transfer of casualties in the event of chemical attacks or incidents. 300 medical practitioners have benefited from this program. We also plan for further training courses in this regard. Finally, Mr. Chairperson, my delegation values efforts put in by the current chairperson of the Executive Council, Ambassador Mohammed Sheikh Bilal, in facilitating the selection process of the next Director General. And I wish to congratulate Ambassador Fernando Arias on his election as new Director General of the organization. We express to him our full support. We have full confidence in his abilities. We also wish to express our deep appreciation and thanks to the current Director General, Ambassador Ahmed Uzumshu. He has led the OPCW with wisdom and ability in very difficult circumstances. His success is largely due to his vast managerial and diplomatic abilities. Thank you for your attention.